Hello and welcome back to my devlog. I'm sorry to be late this time. The weekend was kind of busy, but overall this week I had some free time and I was able to make a few low poly characters. Although one of them I can't really call a character because it's just a practice dummy. So first of all, if you remember last time I did a challenge and made a boar, but it was just a high poly model and not ready for a game. So this time I made a low poly model and created a texture for it. While making this texture, I actually also made an interesting discovery. It's actually something that I knew about, but never thought I could use it well. It's a bake of a height map that represents the distance between a low poly and high poly model surface. I used to bake it if I had some kind of hard surface model and a low poly that was just a plane. But this Borg character has a more difficult low poly and I would always get this strange bake as you see right now. These weird dark lines appear because my low poly has visible hard edges and I never thought that I could do something about it. However, a few days ago I simply thought, what if I subdivide my low poly a few times to get this smooth model and I could use this to capture a height map properly. And this is the result. It looks so much better, and this map helped so much for the whole texture. I mean, the board texture looked kind of flat, and I would have to paint some detail by hand. But now, with this additional map, I won't have to hand paint the model as much as I used to. I was very happy with the model, and it looks almost finished just from baked maps. At this point, I started to feel very excited about the combat system. But first I wanted to test my main character attacks. I thought that having a boar is too much for now. I mean, I would have to make some animations for it, also some kind of a simple AI. And I was curious about how my main character would work, so I decided to make a simple practice dummy for testing. And as always, high poly first, then low poly and then some textures. And this time I also used a height map. I think I'm gonna be using it all the time from now on. I still made a few animations for this practice dummy, because I knew it would take only a few minutes. I mean, it only has 3 bones and just 3 simple animations. An idle animation, taking damage animation, and a sort of death animation where the practice dummy simply falls down. After this, I also made some animations for my main hero. This stage took me some time, because I made 7 animations and I'm also not a good animator. So my main hero now has a combat stance where he is prepared to attack. He can draw the weapon and also put it away. And he has 4 different attacks. My idea is to randomly use those attack animations to make it more natural. After this, I have placed everything into Unity, added all those animations to my main hero animator, and also added a lot of different transitions with specific conditions that actually start to look really difficult to manage. But anyway, time for some testing, so I have placed some practice dummies. So the idea is that my character is in a normal stance at the beginning of the game, but when I press on the enemy, he draws his weapon and runs towards it to attack. When I press anywhere else on an empty area, it runs away, but it stays in a combat stance now. And if I press on an enemy again, it just goes there and attacks. But if I press on something that I want to pick up, it kind of means that the area is clear and my character puts the weapon away and runs to grab that item. And will stay in a normal stance now, unless he decides to attack again. I had many bugs at first, but I fixed all of them. Even if you just start clicking on random places very fast, I made sure that everything would work smoothly. On the last day, I also decided to make it possible for a player to zoom in and out. This was the simplest work I had to do, that took me around 15 minutes, but it really changed how the whole game looks now. Sometimes you really want to zoom in to see something up close. So that's it for this week. I'm really happy that my character's combat looks kind of smooth. But the biggest challenge will be when I add some moving enemies. So creating these enemies will be my priority for this week. I hope you enjoyed the video, subscribe if you did, and have a great week.